When people use the phrase, there's a call of God in my life, they could be referring to he's moving me to a new location or even a new vocation. Or, as is common with most of us, he's bringing me to new places in my spiritual growth. He's calling me to new heights of my practice in following him as his disciple. However we're defining the call of God, it's clear that God moves his people from one point to another. He's always in the process of bringing us forward. And there's a couple of things that I know about the call of God. And the first is, it's never into easier territory. If you're hanging on that tree branch and he says, go out further, chances are, as you keep going, you're going to hear the creak of that branch more and more the further out on the limb you get. It's a scary place to be. So Paul Tripp in his devotional reminds us that God rules every situation, location, and relationship in which his call is to be followed, and that's a great comfort for us. The second thing I know is that God's call is always into safer territory. You might say, well, that doesn't seem like the case, especially somebody moving from the confines of what seems like a safe upbringing to a dangerous place around the world, for instance. But safety is never in our own grip. We are in the safest place when we are in the center of the grasp of the only one who's got all power and all knowledge. Isaiah 31:1 warns us that sorrow awaits those who look to Egypt, metaphorically speaking, the superpower, the army of the time, looking to Egypt for help, trusting their horses, chariots, and charioteers, and depending on the strength of human armies instead of looking to the Lord, the Holy One of Israel. Tripp continues, only grace can work to remind us that faith in God is a resting place and trust in self is a minefield. God stretches us away from comfort and perceived safety to bring us to a more stable and fulfilling place, the center of his grip. And it is always for our good and for our growth. God bless you.